of the most badass bands in the U.S. right now. They're called Dirt. Who's all on the line with me?
Just Raphael.
Hey, man, how you doing?
Doing well. You know, these other guys, they got their social agendas. I was the only one who was available on a Saturday night. You know, Chalice is, who knows what he's doing? He's probably kibitzing with some high rollers. You know, Paul's got to be out there with some other awesome rock and roll drummers. And who the heck knows where Fred is and Scott. These guys are untraceable at all times unless we're doing a show.
Well, they got to get them chicks. That's all I'm saying. Ralph, I just want to wish you a belated happy birthday. I know it was on the 5th, so happy birthday, bro.
Yeah, thanks. Well, I'm trying not to count them anymore, so okay. We're good there, but thanks anyway.
Well, you know, I'm getting old too, so don't mind it. So
the metal keeps you young, though.
Bro, all the tunes you've been sending me are just freaking awesome. And what you guys did, and that's why one of the main reasons why I wanted to bring you on, is what you guys did during the Battle of the Jams. You guys really put such an effort behind it. And I just wanted to thank you for all you did. And it's just amazing. This is probably the first anybody's hearing this, but we got to, last week, we got to about 75,000 people. Can you believe
that?
It's just incredible the amount of people we're getting to. And I wanted to thank you especially.
But yeah.
Well, I can tell you, we were on top of that to the point where we were getting votes within the last 5 seconds of the end of it. So, you know, that other band, I'm not sure exactly how to say the name, Mammother,
yeah.
Great band. And, you know, we think those guys are amazing. I mean, what a great tune that is. I listened to some of their other stuff, really good stuff. They deserve it. But we were on their tail till the last 5 seconds, and I can't take the credit for it. We got to give the credit to our dirt bags, our fans.
Bro, and it was so nail-biting from my end because it kept switching hands, and then somebody would get just a little bit ahead, and then you guys would close it in. But it wasn't the only one. You guys did that against Nightglow, too. You guys really put a hell of an effort in.
Another great band, and I can tell you, one of the nicest things was I saw that one of the band members there were giving us their support in the later match, and you know, I think it was from our back and forth when we were doing the contest. So Dirt feels like, matter of fact, somewhere on Facebook, one of our fans wrote, "You didn't lose," and I don't feel like we lost either. This was one of the greatest things to really get us to come together as a band and really work on something hard. And you know, we're proud of our fans, proud of ourselves, and proud of Mammother for winning. And hopefully, they're going to take metal all the way to the end of this thing, and we're going to see some metal up on that chart.
Well, I was going to mention to you that you still are in the metal category, and you still have a chance to, you know, say your piece there, because this was just to get all the bands into the Crank It Up Award. But your song, My Own Curse, was already there. And one more thing.
And another thing we appreciate so much, because, you know, getting the music heard and getting people to actually take a listen is so tough.
And bro, you guys were just supporting everybody. And that's what this Music Awards is about. And again, I can't thank you enough for showing so much support. Now let's get into the band. How long have you guys been together?
Well, so we got together a few years back. And really, it was a thing, kind of, hey, let's get together and jam. You know, an old friend of mine, who was also an old friend of Paul's, is the one who got us together. And, you know, we had a connection, but family members and things like that. When I went down, I said, this is just a little thing. I'm not getting into another band. It's nothing. And it turned into something, and I had to walk away. And that was a few years back, 3 or 4 years back, because it really made it tough on the family. And we kept in contact, and about a year ago, my wife saw how miserable I was, and she's very supportive, you know, so she said, go back, go get those guys, you know. And Paul and I talked, we called Chalice, you know, got bass tryouts and got Fred, and this is all about a year ago. So we're together just a little over a year. And, you know, it's been a great experience. I mean, we have a great bond. And, you know, we really, I think that the most important thing for us is not listening to the chatter. If somebody says we sound old school or Chalice sounds like Jeff Tate or whatever somebody says, we don't listen, because what we're doing is we're just playing and making music by what our hearts tell us to do. And I think that's what's relating to people, because when people, you know, respond to our music, I think it's that. I think it's the heart in the music.
Yeah, I hear some possible influences in your music, but you guys really have your own sound going. And then having a singer like Chalice, dude, the guy can sing. I mean, when you...
By the way, he comes without an attitude.
Really?
So go ahead and tell me how that works. This guy is the best guy. I mean, you know, don't get me wrong. I mean, he can have his diva moments, like we all can. But no, just kidding. He is a sweet guy. He cares about people. We played the Chance Theater in Poughkeepsie, and behind the Chance Theater, it's not the greatest area, and you have people who are unfortunately homeless back there and walking, you know, behind the theater. And Chalice, an hour, you know, 45 minutes before we were going on, is out there having a full-on conversation with a few people, telling them, you know, giving them a supportive and you know, uplifting, you know, hey, you guys, you know, you could do it, you know, rise up, and you know, and just talking about music. And you know, he's just, the reason I took a minute to say that is because he's so welcoming, that, you know, it's a big part of what makes the band, you know, what we are. We're just, we're appreciative and we're welcoming, and he is the epitome of that, and he's the, you know, the front man in the band. So it's great to have somebody like that when you see so much attitude, especially with people. I mean, no one can deny the guy is a natural voice that is amazing.
But he does all different sorts of things. He's not really stuck into one style. He really has kind of, he can do like a Bruce Dickinson, Jeff Tate type of thing, but then he can get down in the area and all kinds of other stuff. And it's hard to find a vocalist that has such versatility.
And by the way, he has more than that as well. And I can tell you, me and him talk a lot, and I'm always, you know, telling him, you got to expand even more, because, like, I believe in that guy. I believe in everybody in the band, by the way. But I believe in Chalice, I think, more than he does. And I believe that he's a touched individual. You know, the miracle of whatever is in his vocals, and when he puts emotion into it, you could forget it. I mean, there's nobody like this guy. And you know, I know he's in my band. I hope I'm not sounding braggadocious, because it's not what I mean. It's just, he's a guy that I look at and I go, how lucky am I to be in a band with him, and how deserving he is of it, because he's such a good person. And you know, it's nice to be a part of and to watch.
No, it's got to be great, and a lot of the bands in the area got to be envious of you to have such a great singer. But you guys aren't just based on great singer. You got a great drummer, great bass player. Your guitar players are great. I mean, all around. How do you guys go about, like, writing songs like My Own Curse? Like, is it, you come in with a riff or something, or how does that all kind of come together?
Well, you know, because we're all, you know, in the throes of our lives, and we have a lot of responsibilities, we're not able to get into a room and write together. So Paul and I, you know, we're almost, you know, you could say we're like teenage girls as far as being on the telephone a lot. So we're on the phone a lot, passing back and forth ideas, concepts. I'll come up with a skeleton of a song. So I write the riffs and the verses and the choruses and all that stuff. And, you know, on that album, I wrote all the lyrics. So we get it all I get it all together, put a little demo together, bring it down to the guys, and then we work it. And that's when the magic happens. I don't know what happens to these songs. I'm never going to let anybody hear them, but if you could hear the demos, because I can't sing with Chalice, but if you could hear the demos and then hear the finished product, you'd go, is that even the same song? So I don't know what the magic is that these guys insert, but I bring a song down there, like Black Dawn. I remember letting Paul listen to it and him going, yeah, you know, okay, we could work with it. It's not bad. And then by the time we finished it, he's like, that's my favorite song. This is insane. You know what I mean? So they just, and again, I think most of it, it's not technical ability. It's not overwhelming talent. It's heart. When those guys get to it, they just put their heart and soul into it. Just like we did with this contest. I mean, you know, we're the second place guys, and here we are on the interview. And I think a big part of that is even we showed heart, and people like that. And it's honest, and it's who we are. So that's the best answer I could give you. I don't know why it happens, but it just does.
As far as I'm concerned, you're not second place, bro. You guys put a hell of an effort in, and we were talking just little, what I think it was a 4 or 5 votes separated it all. That you guys, like your friend said, you guys were definitely winners. And I love all the stuff you're doing. You've got some upcoming gigs that are quite important.
We do. We're playing, one of the ones that we're playing that I'm really excited about is at Mag's Pizza, and it's for the Scars Foundation, which Sully from Godsmack, I believe, is the founder, somebody high up in that organization. And this was put on, this is being put on, by someone who is a newer fan of ours. She saw us play at the Chance Theater with her dad, and they liked us and, you know, got with us on Facebook. And she said, listen, I want to put on this charity, and I'd like you guys to play. And we're going to be playing with another band. I think they're called Wicked Gypsies. But the big thing about that band is a guy named Jimmy Bell is the guitarist from that band, who's now the guitarist in Autograph, and he's just a monster. And I, you know, I'm looking forward to that. I'm looking forward to getting some money towards this charity. So that's one that's coming up. Then we got another one with a band called Ink right after that. I think the one that you're talking about, the big one,
yeah,
Dream Come True gig, we're opening up for Jeff Tate.
Yep, that's the one
at
I
the
heard.
Chance Theater.
Yeah.
And long after that, we're going to be opening up for Flotsam and Jetsam in New Jersey. But the Jeff Tate gig, one of my holy trinity singers. I have 3 singers that I hold high and dear, and he's one of them. Lifelong fan, and I'm so looking forward to being able to hopefully meet him and shake his hand and tell him how much he's influenced me.
Oh, that's great. How long's the album been out?
Yeah,
that just came out, right?
Yeah, a few months ago. Yeah, it just came out. We've had, you know, I mean, for us, you know, a very small scale, but we've had a lot of nice. We had one guy, he's called the Masked Crusader. He does band reviews, and you know, he found it somewhere, I don't know how, and he reviewed it, and he let us know, and we got to watch a review of someone who none of us know that never knew us, so that was kind of nice. It's been circulating, so we're kind of happy, you know, with that. Even again, we're not anywhere near, you know, our heroes, but we are generating a little bit of a buzz, and the circulation is good, and the people who are enjoying it really love us, and we really love them, and you know, we're just having great shows. It's like being at a family party, to be honest with you. It's been a great ride this past year.
Yeah, and I want to say, I just got a message earlier about 2 days ago from a station manager that I'm on, you know, I'm affiliated with, who is from Connecticut, and all she had was great words for you guys, and I think the word's really getting out on your band, and it's just a matter of time before I think good things are going to happen for you guys. Do you plan on doing any, like, long-term touring? What's like the long-term goals for the band?
You know, we are following this where it leads, and so, you know, the cool thing about life is the future's unwritten, and that's what it is with the band right now. I mean, you know, we have hopes and dreams and aspirations. You know, obviously, you know, you look at concert footage of a Metallica show in France and you go, God, wouldn't it be nice to be able to do that? But then we also know how far-fetched that is. So what we want to do is reach people one by one and take it as far as we possibly can. And you know what? If there's long-term touring that we can sustain and still be responsible to people who count on us, like, you know, our families, obviously, sure. then we would certainly consider that. I mean, it just has to be something that's going to keep us sustainable financially.
Sure. I can totally understand that. As we're kind of winding this down here, you want to give the some of your fans and some of your listeners some background on what else the band's going to be doing in the next few months, maybe, or maybe just, you know, a message that you'd like to give them before we let you go?
Sure. I mean, I want our fans that haven't gotten to get out to see us to know how much we appreciate it. And one of the things that we just did, we opened up for Shoot to Thrill, which is an all-female AC/DC band. They are killer. So if you ever get a chance to listen to these girls, they're amazing. Anyway, my point is, what we did is we provided transportation and purchased tickets for about 30 of our best fans. And, you know, we had a big cargo, a big passenger van that we drove up there. And, you know, and that was just because we wanted to show our extreme appreciation to the support they're giving us. You know, we want to support our fans as well. We want them to know they're not just fans to us. They are our dirt bags. They're the ones who lift us up. So what I would say to anyone out there is, you know, if you get involved with this band, know that, you know, it's all about heart. It's all about feeling. It's all about, you know, it's just all about music taking you to a higher place. When we get into that concert hall and that half hour to 45 minutes that we play, it's us and our fans and no one else exists. And that's what we're about. And that's what I would like to portray out to people. When you come to see us, it's a united front, and it's the best feeling in the world.
And some awesome freaking music. Why don't you give us your social media so everybody knows how to find you on the internet?
So I'm terrible at this. It's Dirt from Milford, Connecticut. And like on Facebook, if you put Dirt Band Milford, you'll find us. You know, you could also look for us on YouTube by searching for My Own Curse. The video's there. Also on Reverb Nation. We're Dirt from Milford, Connecticut, so we're also on Reverb Nation. And, you know, those are the places that I think are best to find us right now. And, you know, you have access to most of our music. We're on all those things that a lot of the bands are on. What sound? You're asking the wrong
SoundCloud,
guy.
Yeah, SoundCloud and all that. I get it. And you're on the Banger Music Hour.
Well, you know, and which is so important. And, you know, we've been listening to you. I've been actually going back and listening to old stuff. I love your format. Love the show. You know, I think
you better love Shady, too.
You know. I mean, you know, a lot of the things that you talk about are also thought-provoking, which I like. You know, you could actually have a conversation about something that you heard on the, you know, when you're talking. And so keep up the great work. And I really hope to see you skyrocket. I would love to see something like that because you deserve it. You're a talented guy.
Brother, that's what this is all about. That's what the Banger Music Awards are about. It's for all of us to lift each other up together. Because you know how the corporate world is. They're not going to grab us and pick us up. So we have to do it ourselves. And if we can do it in a massive collection, like I just told you a few minutes ago, 75,000 people last week. We've probably hit over almost 200,000 people we've reached since this whole damn thing has started. So it's about lifting everybody up at the same time. I can't thank you enough for joining me. Anything you guys need, if you tour out this way in Michigan or whatever, if you're going to states where one of our affiliates are on, you let me know. We'll get you interviews. We'll get you whatever you need to do to help promote the band. Okay, man?
We'll love to keep in touch. It's definitely it's new, but it's been such a great ride, and we love the partnership. So you'll be hearing from us often.
Ralph, you are the man. Thank you for calling, and we'll talk to you real soon. All right.
All right, boss. Thanks.
All right. Bye. That was Ralph Guzzi of the band Dirt from Connecticut.